that needs prayer. Matter of fact, get him in this line here. I want to be right here. Get him to face me. You need prayer? No, you're doing great, Jen. Hey, we don't have any rules and regulations here, all right? Just keep your clothes on. Then that's about time Callie comes running out naked, you know? She's only two. Glory to God. No, you're fine. I like the joy. I just speak joy. You know, the kingdom of God is not eating or drinking, but it's righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Joy in the Holy Ghost. You need more joy in the Holy Ghost. You're a good man. You're a good man. Well, the only one who can make you better. He already sees you better. See, he already sees you how you really are. He already sees you whole. He already sees you a good man, a loving father, a righteous man in him. You understand? He sees you perfectly. He wants you to see his son. And as you see his son, you'll see who you really are in the son. Because he's hidden you in him for that reason. So when you look to him, you'll find your true identity. And you'll feel confident. You'll feel sure and certain about everything. Clarity, no matter what comes your way, no matter where you are in life or what's going on in life, he's in the midst of everything you do. And he will lead and guide you in all spirit and truth. He will cause the sun to shine upon you in the middle of the darkness. He will cause his righteousness to be like a flaming fire coming out of you in the name of Jesus. And Father, we just pray right now for the finished work of the cross to be instilled and totally, Father, we believe that he has received. We believe that we have received. And Father, we receive. We don't trust in our feelings or what we see. We trust in the truth. And your word says, by his stripes, we are healed. By his stripes, I have been healed. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, let your glory fill this house. Let your praises fill my mouth. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Joy, 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 joy. Oh, rebashim, reshelabasohoriate. Joy, 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 joy. Let it fill his heart in the name of Jesus. Let joy fill his heart in the name of Jesus. Oh, Sharabashikidiba Sokoria Haraba Sinkeribom, Brekereba Sonde, Brestideba Harebe Stikidibom, Rebetare, Ramombo Rebestidi di Beshiti di Bosotomo. Just stay in his presence and let God saturate you in his glory. Shikarabasa, Jen. You got a great smile. Yes, you do. I'm glad you came. Well, Jesus makes it fun. You know, I used to be kind of a pharisaical mindset. He came to me in a dream once, and he took me for a walk. He talks to me in dreams a lot. He took me for a walk along the seashore. And as we were walking, we were just kind of dialoguing. I was listening mostly because I was kind of in awe in the dream. Then he stopped and went, psh, and kicked water on me. And started laughing, and he started going like that and throwing water on me. That's my Jesus. He knows how to have a good time. He came in celebration in life. He came to set the captives free, to open wide the prison doors. Those who are held in bondage, whatever that might be, his love for you is greater than anything. He's greater than your past. He's got your future in his hand. He said, for I know the plans that I have for you, not to harm you, but to give you hope in the future. A great future. Your greatest days are ahead of you. Your greatest days are ahead. Yes. Is there anything going on in your midsection at all? You okay? Okay. I know she's pregnant. But no, you're not pregnant. I didn't mean like that. No. Okay. Anybody having something going on in their stomach? Okay. I knew I heard that. Any just want to touch? You want the power of the Holy Spirit? You want to be baptized? You want
to...
Okay. Are they... Well, here's what you got to understand. What are the interior organs? Okay, if you understand what Jesus did, he took what the high priest would do back in the day, after they presented the lamb, Jesus without spot or blemish. They take, cut it, kill it, they cut it apart. There's a reason why they cut it apart. So they took all the entrails and they roasted the fire and threw it in there. That speaks of judgment. So God's judgment fell on the body of the Lamb, Jesus, for cancer, sugar diabetes, scoliosis, you understand? Spinomyalgia, whatever. Every name, right? So you believe that, right? His bones, his marrow. I had a young man come in crippled, and we told him that Jesus took the bones and the marrow, everything, into the fire. And I said, now, my wife said, now see that on the cross. See that on the body of Jesus now, as if Jesus is here right now on the cross before you, and give it to him. He took it. He bore your iniquity. He bore your transgressions. He bore your sin, your shame, all of ours. All your pain, all your sickness onto his body, right? And by his stripes, you are healed, right? Everyone, you are. So now, just receive, right? So your job is just to do nothing but to receive. Say, Father, I receive. Hold up your hand and say, Father, I receive. From the top of my head to the soles of my feet, I give you all my infirmity. I give you all my pain. My word, I release to you because you care for me. Now fill me. Every ounce of her body, Father. We drive out every spirit of infirmity in the name of Jesus. Everything that comes against the knowledge of Jesus, we put it under the obedience of the cross now. Right now in the name of Jesus, Father. Right now in the name of Jesus. Right now, Father. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Right now, right now, right now, any form of blood disease goes in the name of Jesus. Anything to do with any kind of inflammation goes in the name of Jesus. All inflammation goes right now in the name of Jesus. Right now, Father, we believe that she has received. We believe that she has received. We believe that she has received. Oh, there you go. We believe that she has received. For some reason, I don't know why, there's something about it. The Bible says, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. We speak rivers of living water. We speak life. We speak life in every bit of infirmity, every chamber of your heart, every chamber and every fiber of your being right now. In the name of Jesus. Right now, in the name of Jesus. We break every chain. We break every word that's been spoken against you. Either in evil, every word of a doctor, every word of ignorance, every word that's even been malicious against you, we break it and sever the tie right now in the name of Jesus. Right now we just release the spirit of life, the spirit of hope, the spirit of joy. Again, the kingdom of God is not just eating and drinking, but is righteousness, peace, and the Holy Ghost. Righteousness and peace in the Holy Ghost. Now, Father, right now, right now, right now, just let her receive. Just let her receive, Father. Right now, Father, let your anointing flow. Let your anointing flow right now, Jesus. Confirming through signs and wonders. Confirming your word. See, they went out preaching the gospel, the good news, and being confirmed by signs and wonders. Father, you are a sign and a wonder. So, Father, signs and wonders right now. The moving of miracles, the working of miracles. By the signs and wonders and working of miracles right now in the name of Jesus. Saturate her, permeate her, Father, in the name of Jesus. There she goes, there she goes. That's it. Who shout out about somebody every kid? I speak a strong heart. I want you to stand right there because I got to read this over you. Find it. I know it's in here. God is not slacking his promises. Every promise he's ever given you, Mary, this is the season. This is the season. This is the season for a reason. Some things had to surface for this purpose. Well, this is one. God says, my daughter, yeah, 420 and on. 420 yeah, to 23. It says, my son, daughter, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my voice. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart. For they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. Keep your heart with all diligence. For out of it springs the issues of life. When we speak life, into your physical heart. But the spirit of the heart, the wisdom of God and the understanding. Jesus said, Solomon was wise, but there's one here who's wiser than the wise. And he's living in you. God says every desire, for a while there, hope was getting deferred. Hope deferred makes the heart sick. But when desire comes, the promise is fulfilled. It becomes a tree of life, a river of life, a stream of life. And it wells up inside of you. Wells of life inside of you. Wells of life inside of you. God says, I have laid out before you. I've laid out steps before you. I've laid out the plans before you. I've shown you in detail everything that I've commissioned, positioned you into. I've already appointed you for such a time as this. I already brought you into this season. I've allowed you to understand a deeper depth of who I am. And the great I am of who you are, as the I am is who you are. I am a new creation. I am. The power of I am for your life. I am the righteous of God. I am the healed of the Lord. I am the anointed, the appointed, the elected, selected. I am the commission and position. I am the carry of the glory of God. And I will see revival. I am a revivalist. I have prayed. God says you have prayed for decades for revival into Orlando. And every promise that you thought was supposed to come 10 years ago is now the season. Now is the season. Now is the season. Because you have not lost heart. Although there was a moment or two, he just didn't know what to do. You did not lose heart. God says, you are faithful, daughter. And I have looked to your faith and your faithfulness. And I'm getting ready to pour in you such a greater measure of the anointing. Such a greater weapon of wisdom and honor and power and glory like you have never seen or other days no one will ever see. Great is your reward, saith the Lord. Great is your reward. Not one prayer have I not cherished. Not one prayer have I not heard. They still are here in the bowl in front of my throne. Everyone means so much to me. Every tear, every drop has meant so much to me. And daughter, your time of weariness is over. It is time for my provision to be manifested in your life. Far beyond expectations. Far beyond. This is a supernatural, fresh kickstart for your life. Supernatural, fresh kickstart for your life. Man. Oh, shikadada. Oh, shukurada hara hara yatkanina. Oh, ho. Ho. You know, in the old days, they used to throw the seeds down. Then they pull the plow behind it. God said, you've been planting seeds. You've been planting seeds for harvest. Now the plows are coming. Now the plows are coming. Now the plows are coming. They're going to bring it together. And the rain is falling. And the rain is following. And they're going to see the harvest that you have been praying for. You're going to see a mighty moving of the Spirit and a shifting of tides. The Lord said it's a shifting of tides. It's a the baton has been now transferred. Oh, to the runners. Oh, God says, I have put you high upon a rampart this day. You're going to see more clearly and understand more clearly than ever before. And God said, there's going to be no fear in it because my love, my perfect love for you casts out all fear. You'll know things and be confident in them, and there won't be worry attached to it. Many times when you've seen things, the enemy would come in and try to steal the seed of faith that God has given you and cause you to worry through it. Even though the prayers went out, they didn't go out as effective as they should have because there was a little bit of worry attached. But God says, those days are over. Those days are over. I'm putting in you a new spirit. I'm putting you in a different spirit. There's a different spirit in you. As in the days of old with Caleb and Joshua, they were men of a different spirit. Having the same spirit of faith, you believe, so therefore you speak. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, your body is healed. Everything, everything, everything. All infirmity goes in the name of Jesus. Everything in the GI tract, Father, everything in the respiratory, everything right now. Everything, cardiovascular right now in the name of Jesus. Order a new heart, a new heart, a new heart. Father, a new heart, a new passion, a new fire, a new heart. See, I'm telling you, the Bible talks about whenever we hope starts getting restricted in our life, we start actually experiencing physically pains and sicknesses and stuff. And God hasn't called. That is not of God. Despair is not of God. Hope is of God. Peace, love, joy. These are all things of God. These are all the attributes of the Father's love for us. Father, in Jesus' name, we just thank you now. Thank you now. From the top of our head to the soles of our feet, Father, just fill our... Okay, new wine. New wine. New wine. New wine. New wine right now in the name of Jesus. New wine. New wine. New wine. Just receive, Mary. Just receive. Just receive it. You need that new wine. It's going to be a wine of celebration. You're going to have... I see you dancing. I see you dancing for... I mean, you know about getting undignified? She's going to be undignified. I see you dancing. Yeah, I just see her dancing even at home in the spirit. I see you dancing to your house. Demir's going to look at you like, wow. But he's not going to be able to resist it. He's going to jump right into the party. Because God has put God has put a new song in your mouth and a new dance in your heart. So you're going to dance. It's funny because Miriam is Mary. It was Miriam that grabbed the tambourine. Come on now. And all the women and started prophesying. You're going to prophesy. You're going to prophesy. You're going to prophesy. Oh, the horse and rider has been defeated this day, and God has put him under the sea. All demonic oppression gone in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Are you praying for you or for your husband? Both? Both? We love both. Boy, it's been a long journey. It's been a doozy. But God says, you don't losey. Your loss is his gain, and his gain. His gain is you. He is gained by you. And his love will never fail you. The enemy's come in like the flood, like a flood. He's come to kill, steal, and destroy all your hopes, your dreams, your life. You too have had hopelessness, wonder, and bewilderment. Like, what the heck? Lord, why again? I feel like I'm here at the 7-11 miles. I've already passed this stone 14 times. Again, Lord, again. And God says, now look deeper, look closer. Look beyond the natural into the realm of the supernatural, the things that I have laid out for you and the plans that I have for you. God is building hope and restoring. That's why that scripture in Jeremiah 29 just keeps coming up. For I know the plans that I have. God's plans will not fail because God will not fail you. See, when it's His plan, He watches over His plan. He unfolds His plan, not yours, His. But the Bible says, do you not know that those who are joined with the Lord are one spirit? So God's going to reveal by His Spirit, not by might, not by power, but by His Spirit, saith the Lord. The plans that I had to even get before the Lord and said, Lord, we got to have a layout. What you want this ministry to do again? I feel like we're just going around those 7-11 miles. Yes, the teachings are great. The anointing is great. But God, there's something bigger happening here. So God has shifted us. He's preparing our hearts for revival. He's preparing our hearts for resurrection power. He's preparing our hearts for the supernatural. So God, Father, I ask you to restore 100-fold everything that the enemy, everything the locusts have eaten, everything they have stolen, every lie that's been sown, every bit of despair that has been experienced, Father, bring in. You trade, morning may last for a night, but joy comes in the morning. God says, you're coming into the morning. You're into the morning after. You're into the morning. You're coming into the morning. Into the morning. Into the morning. Into the morning. Yes, into the morning of my goodness. The morning of my glory. Into the morning of my provision. So, Father, we're believing as a body of Christ, as your sons and daughters, for supernatural provision. Favor with attorneys. Favor with the settlement, Father. Super abounding, Father. Let them be on the billboard. Dan Noonan got me $7.4 million. Whatever that number is, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, they were hurt wrongfully, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, they're not faking this. This has been a real thing. They all got hurt. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, that'll be one way of supernatural finances coming in. We speak divine health right now in their body. I command your heart rate to be right at 120 over 80. Right now, in the name of Jesus, right now, your blood pressure, 120 over 80, we speak life right now in the name of Jesus. I speak to your pancreas to excrete the right amount of insulin into your body right now in the name of Jesus. I speak to your liver right now. Fatty liver to be removed in the name of Jesus. Fatty liver to be removed. I command it right now. I command the retaining fluids to leave your body and the Tommy's body right now. Retaining fluids to loose them now. Loose them now. Loose them. She's going to have to go pee here in a minute, I guarantee you. God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we confess and we declare that Tommy will have a new heart. That he will be sitting on his front seat worshiping you during these days of revival up and coming. He's going to be, he's a soldier. Tommy's a servant, but he's a son first. But he has a servant's heart, the heart of a warrior. Sometimes we go to our hiding place, but Jesus looks beyond like he did Gideon. See, Gideon was hiding in the threshing floor. He was hiding from the enemy. He was hiding. But see, God knows our hiding place. Even if we feel fearful sometimes, he comes right to where we're at and looks at you and goes, oh, mighty, glorious warrior, woman of valor, woman of honor, woman of my heart. He looks beyond what we see ourselves as and see how you really are. He calls, see, he's a God, come on, that takes dead and brings to life, that calls those things that be not as though they were. He's a God of faith. He's a God of wonders. He's a God of the supernatural. He's a loving Father. There's no reason why, if you don't want to be bound to this wheelchair, if you don't want to be, you don't have to be. Do you believe that you receive healing? Do you believe that Jesus has healed you? He has taken all your infirmity, and by his stripes you have been healed. You believe that you have received everything he came to give you. Total healing. Total healing to all your organs, operating at maximum potential. Your immune system, strong and robust. Your legs have strength. God says his promises are, listen, I will put good things in your mouth, and I will restore your youth as a young angel. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not his benefits, who removes all your sin, who blots out all your transgression, who heals all your infirmity, who satisfies your mouth with good things, who restores your strength as a young woman. Listen, Sarah was 90 years old, and God restored her womb. She was so attractive at 90 years old that two kings wanted her and would kill for her. That's literally, listen, it's not spiritually restoring only. It was literal. He restored her youth into her body. That's the covenant that we are built upon. The promises of God are yes in Christ and amen in Christ. Not, man, maybe so. Yes. Yes. Yes, daughter. Yes, I have healed you. Yes, I have taken all your infractions, all your infirmity. You have strengthened your legs beyond your years. Your best days are ahead of you. Do you believe that you'll be the alive and remaining at the returning of Jesus? I do. Are you ready to go home yet? Then you got it. You're here to fight the good fight of faith, aren't you? Yes, you are. You're a warrior. You're a warrior. You're a warrior. You're a prayer warrior. You see things that God shows you and reveals to you. Yeah? It was? Well, look for the good in whatever God gives. Amen? And even if the enemy comes, look for the goodness of God through it all. Because, oh. Yeah? We've been praying for the school system. So yeah, God wants you to have that fight. He gave you a dream so you know what to pray for and to break that stronghold, to break all those things, all the opposition coming against our school. Our children, the two of the most safest places in our country, actually three. There was three safe places. One was the womb, other was the school, and the other was the hospital. They've all become very dangerous now because of all the corruption. The greater is he. So God wants us as intercessors to break down the deception, to open the eyes so people might believe and know the understanding that they're calling, which is in Christ Jesus. They come in the saving knowledge of Jesus. We don't have a war of flesh. We're not going to go, what were you? We get on our knees. Our battles are won on our knees. Our battles are won in on earth. It's already won in heaven. We get earth to line up with heaven as we pray and believe. We initiate God's power and his grace for every situation. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we just agree with her right now for the school system, Lord God, for these teachers. We agree for great grace and great favor. We come against any opposing enemies right now, all the adversaries, Father. Jesus, you said you prepare a table before in the presence of our enemies. As we look to you, as we commune with you, as we call upon you, as you are in the midst of everything we do, you are moving in our behalf. You do the work, Lord. As we focus on you, you are operating. We rest in you. You work for us as we rest in you. So right now, Father, we're calling in that whole administration that is causing this failure and deception to fall. And our new righteous delegation, a new righteous delegation to be in its place, to put in its place right now. In the name of Jesus, that righteousness be restored in our schools. And Father, to be a safe house again for our youth. And to be a safe house for our children. And let young leaders come out of that. Let young leaders speak the word of the Lord with precision and accuracy. You'll raise up Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's, Father, with governmental authority, speaking in the things of the Spirit and in the natural, Father, and seeing them in the natural, in the name of Jesus. And Father, you know, I was teaching today on Psalm 30, as you receive 30-fold. Remember you said before, you started using your walker? That was the 30-fold. Now we're going to believe God for the 60-fold. You'll have more strength. You can put the walker aside. You won't need this. Unless you want... I mean, we're going to take your Cadillac away. Is that okay? You won't need this. You won't need this anymore if you don't want it. If you like it, you can still... Right. Ah, see? Okay. I like that. Well, actually, I wanted to borrow from you, but listen. You like it because it's kind of comfortable to cruise around on. But you don't want to need it. You heard that. Yes, come on, start speaking. Come on, speak it in now. Speak what you want in your life. Speak what you want. I want to be able to walk. I want to be able to move. I want movability. In the name of Jesus, Father, I believe that I have received. I believe that I have received. Get yourself in a place of faith when you stand up. Believe that you have received and just stand up. Just believe that you have received. Just believe that you have received. Say, Lord, I believe that I have received. I believe that I have received. Is that feeling good?
Jesus.
In Jesus' name. Come on, Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus. Father, strengthen vitality to those legs. Father, let the flow of the blood, oxygen, everything through it, every vein, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, you don't do anything halfway, Father. We speak to 30, 60, 100-fold into Allison's life right now in the name of Jesus. 30, 60, 100-fold into her life. Father, we believe that she has received by your anointing. Jesus, you came for this reason. You came for this reason. You came to set the captives free. You said the lame will walk, the deaf will talk, the blind will see, and the deaf will hear. There's no thing that will keep the righteous down. The righteous may fall seven times, but they get up every single time. Father, we thank you that she gets up in her righteousness according to having faith in Jesus.
Take a step.
You want to take a step or two? In the name of Jesus. By faith. Say, Lord, I have received. Say, Lord, I believe that I have received. I believe that I have received. And you're wearing red stripes today, too. Just one foot. One step. Yes. borrow this now.
I got me a scooter.
I don't know about you guys. I'm going to ride. I got a little wagon on the back. This tear is going to turn into joy. Let it flow. Let it flow. Come on. There you go. Let it out. Go ahead. Let it out. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Laugh it out. Cry it out. Just let it out. Let it out. Come on. It's healing comes when we let go. Healing comes when you let go. Healing comes when you let go. Healing comes when you let go. All the pain goes. All the pain goes. All the disappointment goes. All of it goes in the name. All the hurt goes. All of it goes. All of it goes in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be loosed. Woman, be loosed. Be loosed. Be loosed. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on. Come on. Just let it go. Thank you, Jesus. Filling me with your Holy Spirit. With fire.
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 Fire. Fire in the name
fire.
Of Jesus.
Fire.
Revival. 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 Awakening. Revival. In the name of Jesus. Fire of revival. Fire revival. Fire revival. Thank you. Gatekeeper. 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 Door opener. Gatekeeper, door opener. Gatekeeper, door opener. Fire, fire, fire. Out of your belly shall flow. Out of your belly shall flow. Out of your belly shall flow. Rivers of living water. Out of your belly shall flow rivers. Rivers, rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. Spring forth, O well. Spring forth in the name of Jesus. Right now, bring in healing. Bring in wholeness. Deliverance and life, celebration, joy in the Holy Ghost, 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 joy in the Holy Ghost. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. God, you are so faithful. You are so faithful. You are so faithful. Breakthrough. Everybody say, my breakthrough has broken through. Oh, good. Come on up, gentlemen. Get caught up. So, come on up, guys. Let's just get the power of agreement. God is so gracious. He is so kind. He is long-suffering in everything we go through. He's so patient. Isn't he? He is so patient. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Father. Father, we just thank you for Tom so much. He's been such a blessing. Father, he's a blessing to every place he touches, everywhere he goes. Father, he's such a good son and such a good servant, Father, in the house of the Lord. God's a day of promotion is at hand, says the Lord. The day of promotion is at hand. Your heart has not gone unnoticed. God says it has not gone unnoticed. It's at hand. Healing is today. God says today is the last day of any mourning. This is the beginning of a whole new life for you. It's a whole new life. Elevated in the spirit of life, because the law of the spirit of life that is in Christ Jesus has set us free from the law of sin and death. And God says this is a time of great reckoning, saith the Lord. This is a time of great understanding and great revelation. This great sonship that I've called into, and this great honor of I'm telling you, it's not by happenstance you're in this house. It's not by happenstance we met all those years ago, 6250, when God brought you into our life and been such a light and a beacon and a hope and such an encouragement to this ministry. Even when you weren't here, you were an encouragement to the leadership of this house and to the people of this house. You've always encouraged and never discouraged. You always brought hope and never doubt. And God says, it's coming back at you. It's coming back at you 100-fold. It's coming back at you 100-fold. It's coming back at you 100-fold. I'm getting ready to blow your doors off. I'm getting ready to blow your socks off. I'm getting ready to cause a whirlwind to come about you. I'm going to turn everything around. I'm going to turn you upside down. It's an upside down, inside out kingdom of God. All your theology is going to be rattled around. It's going to be coming to the ground. It's going to make a mighty sound, saith the Lord. Oh, yes, you're going to be a son of thunder. Because the words that you speak of my abounding grace will echo, echo, echo like thunder through the mountains. Like thunder through the mountains, saith the Lord. And right now, Father, healing, total healing, total healing, total healing. For every plan and divisive plan the devil had against Tom, God, you're gonna bring it for a greater glory and a greater purpose and a greater anointing, Father, to be able to articulate your word and the healing anointing flowing out of him, Father Lord, through the word, through the power and demonstration by that word, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh, I just seen saddlebags falling off. There's just everything just falling off. Just everything else that's just, even that's weighed you down some, Father said, it may seem like a light burden, but I didn't want you to carry that anyways. No worries, no fear. No worry, no fear. No worry, no fear. For my burden is easy. Come on, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I don't put a burden on you. I carry the burden. Don't worry. I got you on my shoulders anyways. How could you be carrying anything, the Lord said? I got you wrapped around my shoulders. You're wrapped tightly around my neck. I'm wearing you like a necklace, the Lord said. I'm wearing you like a necklace. Oh, and it feels good. He says, and you feel good. You're a good son. God talks weird like that sometimes. That's what I love about it. But we understand what he's saying. You've seen that picture in your mind, didn't you? I mean, you're just hanging on like that box people wear around. That's you, man. You're just hanging on. Hey, I'm with my daddy. I'm hanging on, man. See, you know who to hang on to. You know who has your hope. You know who he is. And that makes all the difference in the world. So your joy is definitely here. Your other joy is there, but the joy that God has given you, you have an abounding joy that no man can take from you. Because your joy doesn't come from yourself, it comes from him. You got him, you got everything. The whole package, the whole enchilada, the whole tomato and everything, baby. Throw in the cheese and you have tongue. Love you, brother. Total healing. None of that infirmity, none of that anymore. Gone in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God just show himself good. What's going on there, young man? That's his job. Lay it on him, Father. Woo, you almost felt something come out, didn't you? Didn't you?
Woo. Woo.
We are a peculiar people. Because we trust in an invisible God who's visible everywhere you look. He's all-inclusive, all-empowering. So, Father, I know that your son is at a place now. He's at that fork. He's at that fork in the road, Father, saying, Lord, which way, Father? Father, I don't want to move without you. I don't want to go anywhere without you. I'm depending on you, Father, and your plans. Father, show me the plans. Show me the ideas. Show me what you want me to do at this point and venture of my life. Lord, you said if anybody lacks wisdom and understanding, you'd give to them in boatloads, Lord, in abundance, Father. That Jesus, lay it on them, Jesus. Lay it on them. We declare your favor and your grace. We declare supernatural abounding finance. We declare that this family be set free from all debt within this season. Within this season, a season will be anywhere between 3 to 12 months. In this season of their life, all debt canceled. Never late, always early. Never late, always early on every payment, every plan, every desire. Never late, always early in the name of Jesus. Now I'm just seeing right now by the Spirit, I'm literally seeing catapults laden with liquid gold being shot your way. Catapults of liquid gold being shot your way. The Bible says that the Holy Spirit will overtake you with blessings. I see the catapults coming from behind you and overtaking you with blessing. I see a great transference of wealth coming your way. I already see the gate being lifted. Oh my God. I just seen a big, huge gate the size of the Hoover Dam being lifted up and gold bullion just pouring out all over you. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, it's that time for that financial shifting. And I'm speaking this over this ministry and everyone in this house. It's the time for the financial shifting and the abundance to be pouring in so we can do the work of the ministry. We won't go back to our day-to-day lives and jobs. We will be in the streets, not in our seats. We will be seeing people set free. Revival. Revival. We're claiming awakening and revival through this ministry. This city is turned upside down. We are movers and shakers. We are movers and shakers. We are movers and shakers for the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name. So, Father, right now, great favor. Great, great grace. Well, wait a minute. You got to do something here. You got to remind you of something. Oh, there's that road. There it is. There it is. Wait a minute. Got to remind you of that ring on your finger. Got to remind you of that position of authority. Got to remind you of who you are. And it's not just Abel. Daddy said, it's my best road. It's my road. That's, I close you in my room. Wear it. Wear it with joy. Wear it knowing that my favor, my grace rests upon you. That my righteousness is in you. That you are golden to me. I know your heart. See, I see beyond the infractions and I see the motive and position of your heart. You are a son and a servant. You are a son and a servant. You are a son and a servant, and you will humble yourself. You have humbled yourself before the Lord. You're not afraid to roll up your sleeves and get your hands dirty, the Lord said. You'll scrub toilets. You'll scrub toilets. You don't care. You're just happy to be in the house of the Lord. But God said, I haven't called you to that, but your heart is willing to do that. I've called you to greater things. And God says, I'm going to remind you of the, what you're shod with. I didn't tell you to remove your shoes. I said to put them on his feet. Because I want him to know that he is totally redeemed. I want him to know that he is totally favored. I want him to be able to walk into my presence anytime he wants. I want him to know that he's always on the go. I want him to know that my glory is upon him and in him. That those shoes that I have shod his feet with means I have not only redeemed you, but I have blessed you. So you're blessed coming in and you're blessed going out. You're blessed in the city. You're blessed in the field. And I have brought the fatted lamb before you and showing the sacrifice of my son that all things have been removed from you and all things now have been given to you. The things that had held you have been removed from you, that all things have been given to you. All things have been given to you. Freely you have received. Freely you will give. Because I know this guy's heart. If he has the last dollar and somebody needs it, he'll give it to you. He's always the first one in his pocket. He has no problem. See, I know he has no problem with money. And God's growing you better than that. You know what I'm talking about, right? By the Spirit, you know what I'm talking about. God's growing you better. See, God's called you. I'm not talking a few hundred dollars. I'm talking millions of dollars. They're going to be placed in your hands. Millions of dollars. Millions of dollars. For the work of the ministry. Yeah, it's there. It's already there. It's already yours. Now it's time to see God as your soul prospers. God doesn't want any harm to come to anyone. He wanted you to get your mindset back with Christ in the center for the glory of God, for this end time revival. We need a great land. We need an enormous building. This is not going to be like, I'm telling you, it's going to be like way beyond us. It's going to take multitudes and many people on staff, many people praying for people. I see hundreds of thousands and millions of people walking through the doors. I see the ground. Testify to that, Pastor. The ground so full of people. It's going to take so many, so many. But but nobody's going to care about their position. Our eyes are going to be on Him, only on Him. As we behold Him, His glory is released. And the moment people touch foot on the ground, instantaneous healing and deliverance. Because of the unity, the glory you have given to me, I have given to them, that they might be one. The good opinions you have of me, Father, I've given to them, that we might be one. Knowing that Father loves us. Hey, man, there ain't nobody greater in this room. I'm still just His favorite. But there's nobody greater in this room. Amen? The only one great that deserves all the glory is Him. He's the only one that's worthy of the honor. He's the only one worthy of our praise. Amen? Hallelujah. We get the great... Thanks, but He gets to pray. Everybody, stretch your hands out. We're going to stand in proxy for Ty and you. Just all inclusive right now. Father, they go ahead, man. New clients. Father, bring the right clients. Look, whatever God has called you into, you're anointed in that. Don't ever think that your job, if it's a medical industry, or if you're right now doing computers or doing Xerox, or I'm building a wall, it doesn't matter. We're anointed for that, and God's favor's on our life in that. Are you with me? God will cause the increase in that. Oh yeah, there's other things, but don't ever say, well, I'm just called to preach anyway. No, you're called to be where you're at for this time and this season, and God has anointed you for that. And in that anointing, get you great favor for God's supernatural provision. There's a word for everybody. God's supernatural provision for our lives, so we can do the work of the ministry. So, Father, the right clients for her and Ty, every plan of the enemy, every bit of oppression that's tried to come and snuff out what they're doing, Father, it has no way. For every weapon formed against them will not prosper. Every word of judgment that has come against them will fall back on their enemies or their foes tenfold, hundredfold, Father, that they will stand judged by the own words that they try to judge them, Father, because on that day, your judgment will rain on them as your favor has rained on them. So, Father, your great grace and favor right now in the name of Jesus, we break every word, every plan of the enemy. We just see greater things, greater glory, greater peace, greater unity between you and your son. I just see right now your whole entire, even Cody and his wife and his children right now, I see a great implosion and explosion of God's goodness. I see a greater revelation. And I won't be surprised within the year or two that they're not moving to Orlando. I won't doubt that fact that they're going to be moving. Many people are going to be drawn. You guys believe that? I see many people coming from north, south, east, and west. They're going to come in droves. They're going to come in buses. Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, great grace and great favor. Great grace and great favor. Great grace and great favor. Over Andy and Ashley and our little baby daughter here. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you for them. We're just asking right now, Father, for the superabounding grace. Great grace and favor, Father, at His work. Lord God, we're talking promotion. Father, she'll have her own store. Father, we're talking promotion, that she has her own store. Great grace and favor. Do men these things are impossible? God, things all are impossible. You're His daughter. You're His daughter. And He positions you for glory. You are positioned to reign in life. You are positioned to be blessed through Christ. He holds nothing back. Lord, hold nothing back. Hold nothing back for her and Andy, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let this family be established in your righteousness, the abounding grace, Father. Blessings coming in from the north, south, east, and west. Father, just overflow, overflow, overflow. So much that they can give out. We are blessed to be a blessing. So much that they can give out in abundance, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we decree and declare it right now, Father. We just sanctify their marriage. We speak a stronger heart, a stronger unity. Father, and Maddie, Lord, I just pray that, Lord God, that she is fortified and strengthened and understanding beyond her years, even as a young daughter. Father, this family grows so tightly knitted in the love of God, Lord. You can't tell one from the other. That the enemy sees them as a threat because they are threaded in your love. Jesus, that he runs in terror He runs in terror from them, Father, because the glory that's revealed upon them. I'm speaking to the whole church right now. The glory of the Lord's revealed on you so much, the enemy runs in terror. You don't even have to open your mouth. All you got to do is wake up in the morning, and they're running. Your heart is precious. God, I've seen a change in you over the years, and I've watched God operate in your life. And God says, I'm just rolling up my sleeves. I'm just getting started with you, daughter. We got a long romance to go through. He says, I'm going to love you so much.
Yes, Ashley.
You're going to experience his love so much, Ashley, like you've never experienced before. You got a love of a good husband.
Yes.
But you're going to have an abounding, abundant love of a great God. A father who's going to love you so far beyond any man could ever do. And you're going to walk in such great love and kindness and patience. We're all going to see you one day, and we're going to go, you're going to walk in, and it's going to be like, we're like, whoa, dude, really, seriously. Because why? Because of the joy that fills your heart. People are drawn to joy. They love joy. When they see joy on somebody, they can't help but go, oh, man, I got to get around you. What's your trick? I just give in and let Jesus do it. Amen? Thank you. We love this young man. Lord, blessings, 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 blessings. Lord, let this be a time of new ideas. What he plans and ideas, Lord. Let this be a time of greater songs. Let this be a time of greater ingenuity. Let this be a time of greater ideas. Let this be a time of a greater anointing with you, Lord. Understanding the depths of your heart, Lord God. Jeremy, I prophesied of you years ago about these great songs on the earth coming out of you. You've done some great things with your stuff on Blue Jay, but God said, that's good. Yep, and that's desire. It is. But let me tell you, there's some songs going to come out of you for this season. God's going to impart into you some lyrics, some songs that are going to come out for this season. And it's going to usher in a great and mighty revival anointing. And many sons and daughters in here, I want you to listen really clear, because God is getting ready to impart into you. God says, if you incline your ear to hear what I'm about to give, you'll manifest it in the glory in which I have sent it. All heaven will be released in this earth, and it's going to cause men's heart to melt in my goodness and my grace. And now come into the presence, and it's going to cause healing and deliverance and wholeness and health. It's going to cause such a rampart of joy and such a great abounding. I see oceans and oceans and oceans of people worshiping under these songs. Worshiping under these songs. Worshiping under these songs. These are songs of the Father. That, listen, they have been held back until this day. I know. To this day. Listen. God has held these, he has held these songs back for this hour. We are the 11th hour church. This is the great awakening move of God. Like the earth has never seen. God says, take it seriously. Take it seriously. The sound is the sound of many waters, filled with grace and love and hope. The most holiest place God did, he put the mercy seat, which speaks of God's grace. The most holiest place abides in us, and that's the mercy and the love and the grace of God. Grace is the highest holiness. Grace is his highest holiness he displays through his Son. In Jesus' name. So these are songs God's going to pour in you. Do you guys agree to that in Jesus' name? In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. They're going to go all over the earth as the waters cover the sea. And it's going to bring forth a greater knowledge of the glory of God, God's good opinions, ideas, and plans. God says you're going to take a lot of the messages from this place and put them into songs through the revelation of the Holy Spirit. You're going to bring that out in the open. And I'm telling you, the moment people hear the songs, there's going to be instant delivery. There's going to be instant revelation. There's going to be instant wholeness. I'm telling you, the songs are going to come out of this young man and this ministry and this young lady up here and this worship team. I'm telling you. And the worship team to come on. Father, we prophesy minstrels up here. We prophesy keyboard players and guitarists and percussionists, Lord, and singers.